Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala Nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala Ali wa sahbihi wa sallam. Amma ba'd. Ahabatifillah, a question was asked. Assalamu alaikum. I hope you're doing well. Just some quick questions. Is FAFSA or financial aid haram? Is working at Amazon haram in the factory because you may pack anything? Is there any halal positions? Also, if one works in a restaurant with a TV, is his money haram? Jazakallah khairan. First and foremost, as far as the financial aid, most of the financial aid packages in the systems in America, they involve a riba loan. So if it's a riba loan, then of course that's muharram. If they're giving you a grant is like a stipend they give you. There's no attachments of, you don't have to pay it back. It's not a loan. They are paying for you. That's fine. Or if you get a scholarship. And so my advice is for those people who want to study in a university or what have you, that they should strive their utmost to find scholarships, to look and get busy. And the one who strives is the one who will attain. So strive your best to find a lawful scholarship, because there's so many scholarships out there to study for free, or at least have some of your education financed. The second point, aspect of the question is working at Amazon haram because you might have to pack a package which has something muharram in it. No. You can work at Amazon, bi-idhnillah ta'ala, and because the ghalib that you're going to be dealing with is halal. Mostly, you know, the asal is halal. And if you have some shubha or something doubtful that comes, you don't have a, you fear Allah as much as you can. Ittaqullah mastata'tu. Fear Allah as much as you can. Because mostly, not just in the West, but in the world, you will find that most or many forms of employment have something intertwined with haram. And that goes for example, in the Muslim lands. For example, you may teach English, as myself, as an educator, and the books have pictures of women, you know, and boyfriend and girlfriend. They have many scenarios, and you fear Allah as much as you can, and you try to direct the lessons in a manner in which you are highlighting either the haram to show that it's muharram, that you're not glorifying it, and so on and so forth. And you try to censor things as best as you can, or control things as best as you can, and fear Allah as much as you can. The last point, and that goes with the, it really falls into the last criterion too. If you're working at a restaurant, even if it's a halal restaurant, they have a television, okay? So if you believe that televisions are haram, then that's going to be in your workplace. If you have a better workplace, then go to a better workplace. But fear Allah as much as you can. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.